The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
With a large crowd gathering and people from every town finding their way to him, Jesus used this parable. A sower went out to sow his seed. As he sowed, some fell on the edge of the path and was trampled on. And the birds of the air ate it up. Some seed fell on rock, and when it came up, it withered away, having no moisture. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew with it and choked it. Some seed fell into rich soil and grew and produced a crop 100-fold. Saying this, he cried, "Listen, anyone who has ears to hear." The disciples asked him what this parable might mean. And he said, "The mysteries of the kingdom of God are revealed to you. For the rest, they are only parables, so that they may see but not perceive, listen but not understand." This then is what the parable means. The seed is the word of God. Those on the edge of the path are people who have heard it. And then the devil comes and carries away the word from their hearts, in case they should believe and be saved. Those on the rock are the people who, when they first hear it, welcome the word with joy. But these have no root. They believe for a while, and in time of trial, they give up. As for the part that fell into thorns, this is people who have heard, but as they go on their way, they are choked by the worries and riches and pleasures of life, and do not reach maturity. As for the part in the rich soil, this is people with a noble and generous heart, who have heard the word and take it to themselves and yield a harvest through their perseverance. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, based on today's Gospel, one of the questions that comes to my mind is, how can we bear fruit in 100-fold? The answer to this question is found in today's readings. In today's first reading, St. Paul reminds us, both the readings deal about sowing. He reminds us there, whatever is sown has to die. God's word has been sown into our hearts. If that word has to bear fruit in my life, I have to die to many things. The worldly pleasures, the riches around me, the desires of the flesh, I have to die to myself, then I will be able to bear fruits. Word is choked and trampled upon by the desires of this world. So one needs to be careful that these things do not choke and trample the word of God. And the second thing that all of us need is life of prayer. Why do we say that? Why do I say that? Because when the seed is in the womb of the earth, it has to go through dark moments. It has to wait patiently. There are also dark moments in our life. We also need to be patient to experience the blessings of God. And in today's responsorial psalm, the psalmist puts it rightly, I will walk in the light of the Lord. Yes, dear brothers and sisters, this needs to be something kept deep down in our hearts. Whatever may happen to me, I will be a person of prayer. I will always walk in the light of the Lord, in the presence of the Lord. And thirdly, if this word has to grow in our life, we need to read word of God. We have to give priority to word of God in our life. Saint Jerome says, ignorance of scriptures is the ignorance of Christ. If I do not know Christ, the basic reason is I do not read the scriptures. When I read scriptures, when I reflect about word of God, I come to know more and more about Jesus, more and more about God. We remember today our Mother Mary, especially being Saturday. Speaking about her, Saint Luke in his Gospel, chapter 2, verse 19, he says, Mary pondered upon word of God. She reflected upon word of God, meditated about God's word. Yes, dear brothers and sisters, if one has to bear fruits in hundredfold, he or she has to give priority to word of God. Let us pray in and through the prayers of our mother. First and foremost, we may die to ourselves. Secondly, we may persevere in prayer. And thirdly, we may read word of God. For these graces, let us pray in and through the intercession of our Mother Mary. Amen.